We want to look at the me tense, which is the perfect present, you know, in English. The perfect tense me is equivalent to the English present perfect as have or have done something, okay? In Swahili, the perfect tense me expresses an accomplished or a completed, you know, act or action. It may also be used to express a state of being, such as being tired, you know, or being late, okay? So let's look at these examples that just help us to appreciate, you know, the perfect present tense in Swahili, which is me, all right? This sentence, nimesikia. Nimesikia, okay, and of course the English translation of this sentence would be I have heard, okay? So we can actually even break this sentence a little bit further just to show us what you're trying to say here. Ni being the subject prefix, and then of course we have me, the tense present perfect, and then we have sikia, which is listen, okay? We can also have this sentence, ame kula sasa hivi, okay? So again, it is ame kula, and then the rest. And of course, the translation of this sentence in English would be he, she has just eaten. Okay? We can also have another sentence here that would help us to appreciate this even further. And of course, this is in the plural. Wageni wa me wageni wameondoka, and the translation of this sentence in English would be the guests have left, okay? So again, you can break this word here, wa, the subject prefix, me, the perfect tense, and then ondoka, which is live, all right? And then lastly, we can say this other sentence here, mu me chelewa, and the translation of this sentence in English would be you all let, okay? So again, we can break this into mu, which is the subject, you know, prefix, me, the present perfect, and then chelewa, which is the verb, okay? The me tense also expresses a state of having become used to something, as noted in the following examples, okay? For example, I can say nime zoea, nimezoea kunywa chai asubuhi. The translation of this sentence would be I'm used to drinking tea in the morning. So the me here helps us to appreciate the state of getting used to or being used to doing something, okay? We can also have this sentence, you know, that helps us to appreciate, again, this particular example. Ame zoea kula saa tisa mchana, and the translation here would be he, she is used to eating at 3 p.m. Okay, so as you can see from these examples, the rule is quite simple. You have the subject prefix, then you have the perfect tense marker, me, and then of course you have the verb. Okay, so it's a very simple way of actually seeing how the present perfect marker is used in sentences. So having seen the a perfect present me in the affirmative sense, we also want to see how we negate the perfect, you know, tense me. So in negating the perfect tense me, we simply replace the infix me with ja, okay? And then of course, after replacing the infix me with ja, and then of course we add the appropriate negative prefix before the subject marker. This construction can be translated in English as not yet, you know, an action has not yet been done, okay? Now let's just look at some of these sentences in Swahili and of course with the English translation to help us appreciate how the negating of the perfect tense is done, okay? So our first sentence here, our first one will be ni mekula. Okay, and the translation of this in English would be I have eaten. Okay, so we are negating, we'll say si sijakula, and the translation of this in English would be I have not yet eaten. Okay, another sentence would be mwalimu ame chelewa. Okay, and the English translation would be the teacher is late. Okay, so in negating this sentence, it would be mwalimu hajachelewa. The teacher is not yet late. Okay, another example here would be basi li meondoka. Okay, and the translation of this sentence in English would be the bus has left. Okay, so in negating the tense, it will be basi hali ja ondoka. The bus has not yet left. Okay, another sentence would be wageni wa mefika, and the English translation of this sentence would be the guests have arrived. And of course, in negating this sentence in English, it would be, or in Swahili, first of all, would say wageni ha waja, wageni hawaja fika. And the translation in English would be the guests. Have not yet arrived. Okay, so from these sentences we can see how we simply replace the me with ja when negating the perfect tense. We just saw the perfect tense me, but we can also express the perfect tense me with the infix mesha. Okay, mesha, especially the sha part of this infix, comes from the Swahili word kuisha, which simply means to end, you know, or to finish. Okay, so this infix mesha stresses or emphasizes the point that an action has already, you know, taken place. But in actual grammatical terms, there isn't much difference between the perfect tense me and, of course, the mesha in meaning, all right? The latter, that is mesha, simply puts more emphasis on an action that it has already been done. Now, let's look at these examples just to help us appreciate more what we are discussing here about mesha, okay? So in this sentence, watoto wa mesha kula, the English translation would be the children have already eaten. Okay, another sentence would be kitabu ki mesha patikana, and the translation of this sentence in English would be the book has been found. Okay, we can also have another example, amesha enda kwa basi, and the translation of this sentence would be he, she has already gone or left by bus. Okay, and then of course lastly we can have this sentence walimu wamesha ondoka. Walimu wa mesha ondoka, and the translation of this sentence would be the teachers have already left. Okay, so we can therefore see how the infix mesha is used in sentences, just to help us appreciate that an action has already been done or it is completed. So the negation of mesha is not different from the way we were negating, you know, the me tense. We simply add the negative prefix before the subject prefix, and then of course we replace the mesha infix with the ja, you know, infix. All right, so let's look at these examples just to see how this is done. Look at these sentences. Watoto wa wamesha cooler. And of course, the translation of this sentence in English would be, the children have already eaten. In Swahili, when negating this sentence, it would be watoto hawaja kula. Okay, so the children have not yet eaten. Or have not yet eaten, okay? Or eaten yet, as it were, okay? And then we can also have this sentence, kitabu kimesha patikana. And of course, the English translation of this sentence would be, the book has been found. Okay? In negating this sentence, we'll say, kitabu haki ja patikana. And the translation would be, the book has not yet been found. Okay, and then we can also have lastly this sentence, amesha amesha enda kwa basi. And the translation of this sentence in English would be, he or she has already gone or left by bus. The negation of this sentence would be, haja enda kwa basi. And the English translation would be, he or she has not gone by bus. Okay, so we can see therefore that just as in the me perfect tense, the mesha tense also takes the infix ja, which replaces mesha when negating.